captains this evening for the visiting team.
Senior Ty Mitchell.
Number 33, Jared Chapman.
Alex Wilson.
Number 18, Jonathan Ford.
John Rex.
Number 24, Deshaun Daniels. Number 21, LaVondre Nelson.
Wide receivers.
Your captains for the Lovett Lions tonight. Number 88, Ian Crosby. Number 8, Mason Marsteller. Number 34, Cyrus Wilson. And number 74, Ty Mitchell.
Back in the freshman, Willie Cameron. Defense for George Pierce's unit. Number 3-5 alignment at the nose. Senior pin width, at least up here. It's going to be maybe a little bit of a factor in the kicking game. Not much else. The weather conditions seem to be perfect. Looks like as the captains shake hands here, GAC has won the toss and they elect to the first. So Lovett will go on offense tonight, and Richard will going to need a good start out of the Lions offense, especially the up front.
In their home blue jerseys, trimmed in Columbia blue and white, white pants and those blue helmets. And kicking off, Connor Cox. GAC won the toss, they deferred, so Lovett elected to receive, obviously, and deep for the line, Spencer Lee on this near hash mark, standing around his 5, Grant Haley standing up around his 10. Cox is going to boot this towards the sideline, and somebody's got to come up and go grabbing for it, and I think GAC got it. Lovett did not go after the ball. The ball flew right up, and no one came up to cover it up. They went diving for it. McGranahan looks like he went diving for it, but GAC came up with it and not the start the Lions wanted.
GAC.
Not at all. And Richard,
a lot of first down.
Blocker.
The 35-yard line.
Should have called a fair catch. He went up to perform his blocking duty, but obviously the most critical thing there is to get the ball, and he didn't get affected that kick and pushed it back a little bit. So it might be more of a factor than we're thinking here.
Second and 5, put a man in motion is Peter Whitnock. They're going to swing it out way wide on this sideline. We're giving chase and going to pull him down. We pull down Jeremy McGriff, who caught it right around his 34, and he's brought down by Nick Bowden for about a 1 yard loss back to the 31. And 6 for the Spartans, and they're going to send this time 3 receivers out to the left. They've got 1 receiver to this near side is McGriff. Shotgun set. Spencer's your quarterback. He takes it. He's going to swing it out wide. They're going to pick up a first down just on that far sideline as they swung it out wide to LaVondre Nelson, and Nelson took it across the 30, across the 25, down and run out of bounds right around the 24. Cyrus Wilson,
their little scat back, runs it over there and outruns our defense for about 8 yards and the first down for GAC.
So first and 10 GAC at the Lovett 24. They put a man in motion, his white neck, toward the away from the formation. They're going to hand it to Nelson. No, they're going to keep it. Spencer's going to keep it. Turn inside for about 4 off his left side as he ran that read option and took it behind his left guard and left.
John Toletti.
I think Tommy Wiggs must have ordered these jerseys 7 for him. Shotgun set. Nelson's your setback. 3 receivers to the right. They're going to hand it to Nelson running wide. We're going to chase him out and run him out. Julius Holder wrapped him up and ran him out for no gain right at the 21.
Well, great here. Need a stop for the line.
We'll call it 3rd and 6.5 as they go with 3 receivers to the right, 1 left, and there's a timeout. Coach Coakley calls a timeout. So with timeout on the field, 9:56 to go here, first
and
period.
GAC,
we're scoreless.
It's first timeout of that.
Woo, that was a quick 2. But back to football. Shotgun set, same formation, 3 receivers right, 1 left. Spencer takes out. No, they're going to direct snap it, and we're going to drop him right around the 20. He's going to pull away but still have no running room as the Lions swallowed him up right virtually at the line of scrimmage, but hard running that time by Nelson. Crosby had him. They'll go for it on 4th and 6 from the Lovett 20. They're moving from your left to your right. They put 3 receivers. Actually, it's 2 receivers to the right. They've got 1 tight end. They're going to look to that far side and fire it over the middle. Incomplete. He was going to swing it out to the right side. And then
the first time they had it and converted on their initial first down. And then we saw in warm-ups, that was the one pass play that he struggled just a little bit with.
Shotgun set for the Lions. Candler looks, fires it this near side. Wilson takes it and picks up about 7 or 8 on a nice throw and catch to Cyrus Wilson. He did a good job of hanging with that. He was brought down right at about the 28 by Ross Wood.
Cyrus Wilson gains 8 yards. It'll be 2nd and 2.
Yards after the catch, so 2nd and short here for the Lions.
We'll call it 2nd and 2. It's a long 2. Pistol set. We flip-flop Shane from the left to the right at tight end. We're going to toss it to Haley. He's going to try and come back this near side. He's going to get a block. He's down this near sideline. The 40, the 50, the 40. Haley the 30. Haley the 20. Haley will score! Grant Haley goes 72 yards down this near sideline. He tried to cut it back towards this near sideline, and what a block he got by Willie Candler.
Huge block, a big touchdown by the freshman quarterback for the Lions, and he is jumping up and down like he just scored. Willie Candler, what a block, and he took on a big old guy about twice his size, too. What a run by Grant Haley.
Brooke Shane to snap it, Luke Hart to hold, and Brendan McGowan bangs it through. That Lovett scoring drive, 80 yards, 2 points. And they had two guys with an angle, and he outlegged both of them.
Yeah, that was a good race at the end.
Numbers that you can absolutely not tell because you can't read them. It looks as if deep is Delano Spencer along with Ross Wood. But they're not going to get a chance to return it, as it's a high kick. It's going to be taken by an up man, and he's going to get up across the 35 up to near the 40. It was caught by the up man right there at the 40 by Grant Tolles. So first and 10 GAC at their own 40. They go shotgun set. Spencer fakes it to Nelson. He's going to roll to his right, looking for a receiver. Still got some time. He's going to fire it complete. He's got a tight end. He's going to get into Lovett territory and finally be pulled down at the 30.
That was a heck of a throw right there.
So that play picked up 30 and a GAC first down at the Lovett 30. Shotgun set, two receivers left, one right. He's going to hand it off to his up back, and that's Deshaun Daniels, who's going to get sort of, as we can best say it, rugby scrummed. Second and seven at the Lovett 27 for GAC. Lions lead at 7-0, 7:13 to go. Spencer's going to take it, roll out to his left this time, try and throw it. He's giving chase, and we're going to hit him right around the 25 and drop him right there. We were giving chase. Flood was giving chase, and Bowden just broke down and put him right down on the ground after about.
He crosses that line of scrimmage and starts to run. He ran about 40 yards, but not three there, it looks like.
So shotgun set on third and five. They put three receivers to the right, nobody to the left. Spencer's going to call his own number. He's got running room. He's off that far left side. He's going to follow the blockers and go out of bounds right around the Lovett 16.
He's got a big, 16. Big old tight end look about him, but he's pretty agile and good runner so far. And seen a couple of good throws as well.
Here's first and 10 at the Lovett 16. He's going to hand it wide to Nelson. He's going to try and run it wide left. He's going to pick up about seven. Down inside the 10, down to about the 9, just inside the 9. So get 6:16 to go. Coletti and Martin were finally able to force Nelson out of bounds, but he did pick up 7, almost 8. We'll call it 2nd and 2. And now it looks like GAC is going to have to call another timeout. They took their sweet time coming out of the huddle.
But
with timeout on the field, 6:16. Just inside the 10, we'll call it the 9, and now they're going to go under center this time with a different quarterback. They're going to go with Connor Joseph at quarterback. They're going to hand it to the back, and here there's a flag that goes flying. 2nd and 7. 33 is actually Jared Chappell. Ah, now we've got a new number. Chappell goes under center. He's going to turn, hand it off to Deshaun Daniels. He's going to get away from one man and keep fighting, and he's going to go down right around the 10. He got hit.
Grant Haley walk away. I think he got a little stomach bug after that long run. And he's over the left sideline.
So,
yep. See what happens with him.
So on 3rd and 4.
Another timeout.
This is going to be GAC's third and final timeout. With we'll call it 3rd and 4, though. 3rd and 4 from the 10. They've got to get to the 6. Spencer's back in at quarterback. He's got three receivers to his right. He's going to keep it himself, running to this near side. He's going to try and cut it back in. He's going to pick up his first down across the 5. That is a big quarterback.
Large
in the ball carrier, or he just dragged tacklers as the ball carrier, and Chappell comes back in at quarterback and is going to go under center with an eye set. Two receivers to the right. He's going to hand it off to Deshaun Daniels. Daniels going to try the middle of the pile for maybe a yard down just inside the 4, give him a yard and a half.
All runs since then.
And all runs since then. Spencer threw it complete for a 30-yard pickup, and now they're just going under center. Now they narrow up the formation. They're going to hand it off again to Daniels. He's going to look for a little bit of running room, and he's going to dive towards the end zone, but he's going to go down just short. And there's another flag.
Deshaun Daniels has stopped short of the goal line.
Illegal shift is the call against GA against Hope to the Tigers. Second and goal from the 8 for GAC, moving towards that north end zone. Shotgun set with Spencer. He fakes it to Nelson, going to call his own number, going to cut back inside across the 5, and they're going to mark him down. The ball came loose. So Chappell's going to go under center. Daniels is your quarterback. Chappell's going to keep it himself. He's going to try and fight and drive, and he's going to be stopped just shy of the goal line. It'll bring up 4th and 1. Interesting call. But Chappell is the line of scrimmage. Lovett leads it 7-0 and is trying to have a goal line stand here on their own 1-yard line on 4th and goal from the 1. Chappell's going to go under center with an eye set. He's got an unbalanced line to the right. Chappell's going to take it, run the trap, going to try and run it outside, and he's going to be stopped just short. Just short of the goal line. The line stopped Nelson. Big Will Flood.
Ooh, Big Will Flood got a hold on him. He got a little bit of help there from the outside. And just another big stop there at the Lions.
Lions go eye set, two tight ends. Candler's going to try and keep it, maybe pick up a yard running off his left guard. He does. He picks up a yard. Boy, if we have to kick hard out to the 1. Again, eye set. Dual tight end set. Lee is your tailback. One receiver to this near side. Candler's going to take it, hand it off to Lee. Lee's got 5, 6, 7 yards, 8 yards up to the 9-yard line goes Spencer Lee on a nice little cutback. He was brought down there by Treshard Kimball Brunson.
Big third down here. We'd like to get this first down.
Shotgun set for the Lions. We fake it to Lee. Candler's going to keep it, pick up a first down, dive across the 15, and pick up a Lovett first down. He had a lot of running room.
Breathing room here. Give our defense a breath here.
So shotgun set for the Lions. We've got two receivers to the left. We flip-flop Shane from the right to the left. Candler's going to take it, fake it, call his own number, look for running room, and have none. They really beat us at the point of attack that time, Ward.
Yeah, the left side of our...
And Chris Williams was also in on that. But I will tell you, pretty representative.
Fumble kick and the defense
fumble
steps
kickoff.
Up. And we've got a 7-0 lead here. Second quarter's about to get underway.
So second and 10 for the Lions. We put Martin in motion. Candler's going to look to his left, fire it, complete to Martin up around the 18. He gives up ground, and he's going to get dropped right there. You got to just catch it and run towards that sideline. He was dropped right at the 18 by Chris. Was in on that tackle, not Chris Williams, and he's been all over the field as safety. Lions have it 3rd and 9 from the 17. We're going to hand it to Haley trying to come to this near side, and he's going to have no running room. They really snuffed that out. Wynn Martin.
One first down there, Richard. Give us a little bit of room here for the punt.
Wynn Martin standing right at his goal line. He's going to get this punt away right at the goal line as he tries that rugby kick. It's going to bound across the 45, bound across midfield, still rolling. And the Lions will down it in GAC territory as...
This is almost at midfield here as they start this drive.
So 1st and 10 GAC from their own 47. Spencer's back in at quarterback. He's got three receivers to his left. Spencer's going to take it, fire it out to this near sideline to Nelson. Nelson's going to get hit just shy of midfield and go right at midfield.
Further, and Wilson and the rest of the Lovett tacklers came up for a short gain.
So Chappell moves from quarterback to tight end now, and Spencer's going to go shotgun set with three receivers to his right. He's going to look to his right, has plenty of time, plenty of time. Now he's getting in a little bit of pressure. He's going to throw it high and going to be hit right at the 48. And that was complete to Andrew.
Third down.
GAC sideline, good sure tackle there. Another third down for GAC.
So shotgun set again for... The Spartans, they put a man in motion. They put McGriff in motion. He's going to roll this side. Spencer is. Look to his left. He's under a little bit of pressure. He throws it underneath and passes incomplete. A little too hard thrown for Andrew Lewis and down around his shins. Good pressure.
Catch for the fourth down here. We'll see if they punt.
So GAC will attempt this punt. They're standing right around there, 37. He's going to drive a low kick that's going to bound inside the 10, down inside the 5, and be down right around the 3-yard line. Too bad the Lions couldn't send two receivers. 53 to go here, second period. Lovett leads it 7-0 and goes shotgun set from their own 4. Two receivers left for Candler. His up back is Jamison. He puts Lee in motion, fakes it to him, tries to fire it for Wilson. It's high, too high. Wilson on a little slant route. The Lions will send Wilson to this near side. He's got a little gimpy on him. Looks like Bowden is going to come in motion to this near side as we go in a pistol set. We're going to hand it off to Lee, and Lee's going to get barely back to the line of scrimmage and get dropped right there. Here's a pistol set for the Lions with two receivers on 3rd and 9. We're going to hand it to Lee. He's going to try and come to this near side. He's just going to get wrestled down right at the line of scrimmage. We couldn't block the end that time. And they
are they big? They move too.
So the Lions left to punt it away, and Martin takes it and drives it where it's going to be gathered in right in good field position. The 27 is Nelson. Wind caught it. We tried that
right
rugby kick. That punt was only able to go 22 yards to the 27 as that rugby kick was unsuccessful, really. 1st and 10 GAC at the Lovett 27. Spencer's your quarterback. He's going to hand it to Nelson. He's going to try and go off that left side and really doesn't have much running room as a host of Lions bring him down after about a 1-yard pickup.
Field position against
the Lions. Stop by number 73, Will Flood.
Good start here.
He's 2nd and 8.
Good starting position for GAC.
Here's the Spartans are going to hand it off again to Nelson. He's going to pick up and go off that right side for about 4, almost 5, down inside the 25, down to about the 20 as the clock moves inside. Holder along with Coletti and Snelling's brought down Nelson, but giving 4 down to the 20. 3rd and 2, shotgun set for Spencer. Spencer's going to keep it, run to that right side. He's going to pick up a 1st down, down to around the 15 goes Delano Spencer.
Just got the isolation there, and that was a good read.
And Marsteller and Holder brought him down there, but it's 1st and 10 GAC at the Lovett 16. They're knocking on the door again. Shotgun set, 3 receivers left. 1 single setback, flying Spencer to his right. Spencer's going to run it to his right. He's got 4 or 5 down inside the 15, but hit hard by Coletti, and Coletti's getting up slowly. I think Coletti may have caught his shoulder that time, pulling him down. On the 2nd and 6 now, GAC takes shotgun set. Spencer's going to keep it to his right. He's got running room. Spencer will score. Delano Spencer faked it left, ran back to his right, and scored.
Well, just a good drive there, and all runs again. I think they've switched their theme here is they've gone to a bunch of running plays with their stout offensive line and a big quarterback.
Left of the half, it's a tie game.
They're just
Lovett 7, GAC 7.
All running plays there, but we'll take 3 or 4 first downs and a little bit of time of possession, followed by a nice touchdown.
So Cox to boot it away. Lee and Haley deep for the Lions, and Cox is going to boot this one very short. It's going to be gathered in right around the 21-yard line. And coming upfield across the 30 for the Lions is Jack Stevens. Tyler Rickman stopped Stevens, but it was a 10-yard return for Stevens. Here the Lions in a shotgun set with 3 receivers to the left. Candler's going to take it. Look across the middle. He's under a little bit of pressure and throws it incomplete for a diving Brooks Shane up around the 36. Bring up 2nd and 10 for the Lions from their own 31. We go shotgun set again. 2 receivers this time to the left, 1 right. We run it back inside for Jamison, and Jamison picks up about 2 up to about the 33. He's spun down right there by a very late. The Lions will send Marsteller out way wide left. Wilson to this near side. We put Bowden in motion. We're going to run it inside to Jamison. Jamison's going to get hit right around the 35 and fight ahead to about the 36. It was well conceived. We tried to run a little
shuffle pass.
So Wynn Martin will drop back to about his 22. He'll get this punt away right around his 25. Nelson deep. And this time it's a high kick caught on the fair catch. Right around the 34-yard line. That was not Nelson, rather. That was Tershard Kimball Brinson.
Let's see if the GAC does more of their running game. If they get successfully late.
Spencer's your quarterback in the shotgun set. He's going to fake it to Nelson. Look, run a little screen inside. It's complete up across the 35, up across the 40. It was complete to Jonathan Ford, and Ford came upfield across the 40.
Passes.
Some beef on the line, even their special
So it's second and three from the 42, the GAC 42. Two receivers to the right, one left for Spencer. He takes it, drops straight back, has plenty of time. He's going to throw a little screen back to Nelson, this near side. He's going to get across the 50, up across the 40, into the Lovett territory around the 45. It does look like there's a hole back here right at the 40.
Stopped by
immediately got up and held his hands up like, what did I do?
30.
15 or 16.
So second and 15, we'll call it, from the 30. Shotgun set, three receivers right. And Spencer's going to roll to his right, look downfield, fire it, and it's going to be, almost picked, but Cyrus Wilson was right there and thwarted an attempt to chap
out right again. It seems to be their play of choice, and the quarterback takes his time looking at every receiver potential.
That stops the clock with 3:40 to go. Second, third and 16, they're going to throw it to Nelson, and we're going to run it, knock him out. Martin knocks him out right around the 35. That play picks up four, but it's
going to hit the GAC. Kicking with the wind, although the wind is coming down.
So Grant Haley drops back right around his 39 as the Lions get a fierce rush on, but Haley's going to have to gather it in right around his 30. Big high kick. See what they can do. Knot it up 7-7 here. Late first half. Shotgun set for the Lions. Haley is your setback for Candler. Under pressure, he's going to float it out to Haley. He catches it at the 30. There's a flag that comes out as Haley gets up to the 40 and going to be run out right around the 34-yard line. Did they call a hold?
Candler's pass is complete. I know. Number 10, Grant Haley.
That was a perfect completion.
No, they're going to wave it off. They wave it off. I think what they were calling.
They're only our third first down.
First and 10 Lions, as we say, right at their 43. We put Haley in motion. Candler's going to call his own number, pick up about three, just across the 45, up to about the 46. A lot of talking. Bird County leads Thompson 6-0 in an important game down in Waynesboro. No, they're at the Brickyard tonight in Thompson, actually. Shotgun set on second and 7. Candler's going to take it, roll to his right. He's going to fire it. Just almost picked off by Ross Wood. He was trying to find Wilson in this near sideline. So he makes it third and 7 from the 46. Pistol set. We fake it to Haley. Candler looking for a screen. He's going to throw it complete. Haley cuts it back inside. He picks up a first down. Still on his feet into JAC territory and finally pulled down at the 39-yard line. They're going to mark it right at the 40, actually. But he picks up a good 14 yards, and they love it for being 14 to the GAC 40, 204 to go here in this first half. Line tied up, 7-7. Shotgun set, pistol set. We're going to take it, toss it wide to Haley, and he's going to have to run for his life. He's going to get dropped for a big loss, 15-yard loss as they sniff that out.
GAC has no timeouts, and you might can run the clock out if nothing else.
My sentiments completely. Shotgun set. We fake it to Haley, and now we're going to give it to Haley. Haley's going to get across the 45 and pick up about five up to the 49. Clock continues to run at 107, 106 to go. Lions go shotgun set. Two receivers left. In sort of a power set, we fake it to Haley. Candler's going to call his own number, get across midfield, and dive into GAC territory and brought down right around the 45, and that will probably do it.
Time out, they're going to be saying the same thing. It's too obvious. In the field position, if it goes wrong, fourth and 15 here, we got a lot to get for the first down.
Nobody deep. Martin's going to take it and fire it complete. And he's going to be batted up in the air. And finally gathered up right at the 40. Boy, that was a very strange rollout. Marsteller's getting up very slowly, if at all. We threw it to Marsteller. We can play off a little bit on it. Spencer sends three receivers this time to his left. They're going to snap it direct to Nelson. Nelson's going to get up across the midfield. Lee's going to have to pull him down if somebody can, and they can't. Nelson's going to go all the way down the sideline to score for GAC.
Simple running play, and we had two guys just absolutely miss a tackle. And if they
GAC goes up 13-7 with 1 second to go here in this first half. Cox to attempt the extra point. Good snap, and Cox boots it through. Your new score, GAC 14, Lovett 7. The complexion of this ball game. The Lions were in it, and I can tell you the spotter's not happy. I
should move Grant way up because they've not kicked him at all.
No. So Cox is just going to ground this ball, and the Lions will cover it up on an onside kick.
Conrad Kinsey.
Kind of just squid kick thing, but Lovett's going to make him kick it over again.
So they move it back 5 yards to the 35, and Cox tees it up. They've got deep men to prevent a return, and he's just going to dribble this one short, and Kinsey goes down right there. Not the way we wanted to go in at halftime, but
I was about to be all excited and happy about a 7-7 halftime score.
Peter Whitenet, number 35, Christopher Smith. Kicking off for the Lions is number 19, Brendan McGowan.
Allison Bonds, Samford Bulldogs defeated Laura White and Kerry Bolton's Furman Paladins to advance the Sunday's championship in an automatic NCAA berth. So kicking it just shy of the 30-yard line, and doggone it, I thought we had. Craft would be in trouble right now.
We're down one engine
right now. Our propane heater's struggling right now, folks. First and 10, GAC from their own 35. They put a man in motion. Spencer's going to take it, look to this side. He's going to fire it complete up around the midfield stripe. He fired it complete right across the middle. And 18-yard pickup. Wynn Martin knocked him down there.
At the Lovett, 46.
First and 10, single setback. They're going to hand it to Nelson. Nelson's going to keep it. Go off that right side, left side now, and he's going to get dragged down and pulled down right around the 44-yard line. He picks up.
No huddle, and now they're huddling on this play.
So with three receivers out to the right, Spencer has one receiver to this near side on this second and 8, we'll call it. Shotgun set, he takes it, calls his own number. He's going to get outside for about 6, 7, 8, 9 yards. Very close to that first down. He's down in.
Big third down here.
Third and 1. Spencer has three receivers out to his left, one single setback. He's just going to call his own number, go off that left side and fight back inside. And he's going to pick up about 2 and pick up a first down to the 35. That along with Ian Crosby that time, but he picked up 2 and a first down right at the Lovett 35. Shotgun set again, three receivers to the left. Spencer takes it, leaves it with Nelson, and he's going to get hit right at the line of scrimmage and struggle ahead for maybe a yard.
Guards, we're handling things pretty good here. We just got to watch out for this misdirection play that's coming up.
Rollins, Holder, and Flood on the tackle. They're going to snap it directly to Nelson. He's going to keep it, scramble inside. He's got 10 yards, 12 yards across the 25 down to about the 24, where Rollins along with Crosby have to bring him down.
A little scat back through there. Seems like they get 6, 7, 8 yards or more every time they run that play.
First and 10 of the 24. Again, three receivers to the left. Shotgun set. Spencer's going to call his own number. Run off the left side, stumble down, but he's going to be brought down right there by Craig Rollins.
Delano Spencer goes around the
8:43, 8:42 to go here in this third period. Again, same set. Now he puts a man in motion. He puts McGriff in motion away from the formation, and he's going to fire it across the middle, and we may have a flag there. It looks like Martin may have come early.
Well,
and hit Whiteneck.
You read the slant pattern.
Spencer's pass. Tried to 12 yard.
Offensive attack as Chapel checks in. They're going to have dual setbacks with Chapel and Nelson. Now they move Chapel away in motion, wide. Spencer's going to drop back, be in trouble, and be dropped back around the 24 yard line. Let's see where they mark it. 23 yard line. They mark it. Wow, what a spot. Back to the 22. They only marked it as the 22. Lost 10.
Great defense.
The Spartans are now looking at second and 20
from the 22. Shotgun set. He's going to leave it with Nelson, and Nelson's going to scramble ahead for 10, 12, down to the 10. It'll bring up a third down. Boy, he is hard to bring down. He is very. They're going to make it third and 10 from the 12. His knee went down at the 12. Now they're going to go direct snap to Nelson. Out of this shotgun set, he's going to keep it, run to his right. He's going to kick up 5, 6, 7 yards and be brought down right at just shy of the 5. And they're going to mark it right on the 5. It'll be third. It'll be a 22-yard field goal from almost the right hash. I mean, that ball is just inside the right hash. Let's see what they do with this if it's not a fake. Clock ticks, 6:35, 6:34 to go here.
You saw him practice from this angle in warm-ups.
Long count, good snap, and Cox misses it right. Cox just missed it right. He just gets that miraculous stop and has good, should have good field position out to the 20. I don't know why they're marking it on the, there they go.
Touchdown ball game after a long drive for GAC to start the second half.
So first and 10 Lions from their 20. We go shotgun set. Candler's gonna pump fake it and have to float it out to Wilson. And just out of bounds, he just was out of bounds. He caught it and had almost a foot down. Stops the clock with 6:16 to go. Lovett trails at 14-7, has it second and 10 at their own 20, moving from your left to your right. Two receivers right, two receivers left. We flip-flop Jamison as our running back. Now we're gonna bring Candler on a little, and we try to run the slip screen inside to Marsteller, and that pass falls in. Hear the wind blowing up here on this rooftop. Shotgun set on third and 10, and I think the Lions moved. I think our right side of the line came up. So now the Lions will go shotgun set with two receivers right, two receivers left. Candler's gonna roll, try and float it, and whoa, there's an interference.
Play.
Unfortunately for GAC, Rye overthrown for Shane, but he was clearly hit early before the ball was near him. So pistol set for the Lions on first and 10. We're going to try and run Lee back to this near side. He's got a little bit of a hole and he loses his feet trying to cut back inside and picks up three, almost three, marking it at the 30, just shy of the 33.
Well, looks like
go pistol set to the right. One receiver to the left is Wilson. Now he moves up on the line. And we're gonna go shotgun to Haley, and Haley has no running room as they just slash inside off that defensive tackle position. Big third and 7. Could we get another interference call possible? Trips to the left. Shotgun set for Candler. He takes it, drops straight back, fires it over the middle. Complete across midfield to Brooke Shane on a fantastic catch. Brooke Shane went up high, caught it, and came down with it. Got pasted at the 47 and held on.
Up to make the catch and a big first down in the Lions. That's two conversions on third down here for Lovett's offense.
Shotgun set, pistol set. We flip-flop the tight end, Shane. We're going to take it, hand it to Haley. He's looking for running room. He's going to get to this near sideline. 40, 30, 20. Goodbye. Grant Haley goes 47 yards, and the Lions are threatening to tie it up.
Saw it in the first half there, Richard. He had a little bit of a burst about him. That right passed the interference penalty.
All the way for a Lovett touchdown!
They really overcommitted that time because as soon as he got through, he cut it back to this near sideline, and I mean, he had running room galore.
Well, we talked about that in the first half. The cutback lanes are going to be there for us in the misdirection of cutbacks.
Brooke Shane snaps it. Luke Hart holds. And we hooked it right. It looks like Brendan McGowan hooked it right.
McGowan's extra point.
He hooked it left. McGowan to kick it away. He's got the ball teed up right in the middle of the field, and let's see what he does with it. He's going to kick it up way high, and Chapel's going to call a fair catch right at his 31-yard line and gather it in there. It'll be first and 10 GAC.
Lions, GAC will take over about 31 here, 4-9 left in the third quarter.
Shotgun said they put McGriff in motion on this first and 10 from their own 31. Spencer's your quarterback. He's going to take it. Pump fake, look deep. He's got a man deep, and it's just overthrown as he had Peter Whiteneck streaking down this sideline.
Delano Spencer.
From their 31-yard line. And he's got three receivers to the left. Now he puts McGriff again in motion to the right. Spencer's going to take it, fake it to Nelson, roll to this near sideline to the left. He's going to look downfield and just keep it. He's going to pick up 4, 5, 6 yards across the 35, and it looks like Spencer. So it'll be 3rd and 3 from the 38. Jamison checks in at linebacker for the Lions. Spencer goes shotgun set. Now it's going to be Nelson who's going to keep it. Nelson's going to hit right up at about the 40 and fall short of the first down as he gets hit hard. Holder was there, Wilson was there, Rollins was there, Port was there. They all would. Will stand right around his 25. He'll get this punt array around his 29. And Haley, oh, they're going to fake it. They're going to try and run it wide. And we're going to pull him down for a long, oh, no. And they're going to call us for a face mask. Golly, dog. We had him stop. They snapped it short.
Guys, fight.
And you know what?
Face mask right at the last second as his knee was going down. Really a marvelous tackle to hold him short there. Face mask gives him the first down.
First and 10 of the 45. Nelson's going to take it, roll out, fire it complete to his tight end Lewis. He's going to be scrambled down right around the 49-yard line. They're going to mark it at midfield.
Pass is complete to Andrew Lewis. Hot shot.
2nd and 5. Clock ticks. 2:07, 2:06 to go here. Third period. Lions trail it 14-13. GAC is going to go no tight end this time for the first time. Three receivers, and they're going to hand it off to Nelson, and he's going to pick up 10, 12, 15, 17 yards.
Pass out here to the left, and a good game tackling here by the Lions, led by Cyrus Wilson. And
McGriff went down there right at about the 32 blocker
and
fighting off to make the tackle. 2nd and 8 from the 32. Spencer sends three receivers out to his right. Now he's going to let Nelson take it. He fumbles a snap. He's going to get outside, though, to that right side, makes a spin move and gets inside Haley. Boy, how you talk about howdy. That ball came straight to him off. So shotgun set on 1st and 10 for GAC from the 23, just between the 23 and 22. Two receivers right, two receivers left. He's going to leave it with Nelson coming this near side. No, that's Rashard Brinson, Johnson Brinson. And he's going to get pulled down by Martin. A long 3. This may be the last play of this third period. Shotgun set, three receivers to the right, one left. Is Spencer takes it, low snap, going to call his own number, cut back inside, get hit pretty hard right across the 15 and go down right there, just shy of a first down.
It's third quarter.
John James and Julius Holder in on the stop.
Game here, Richard, with the,
plug up the line, it'll be really third, 2.
Congratulations, Reed Montague, our Lovett alumnus of the week. 3rd and 1 GAC as they flip the field from the 14. Low snap. Going to try and send Nelson off that right left side, and he's going to score. Nelson gets running room, goes off that left side, and scores. How did they did
blocking? Because they didn't throw a flag. There was some good blocking over there.
So Cox will attempt the extra point. It's 20-13 GAC as we start this fourth period. Good snap. And Cox hits a line drive through. And GAC goes up by 8, 21-13 with 11:55 to go. That GAC drive covered.
At some point, you have to have a two-point conversion play ready.
Cox to boot it away. Haley and Lee deep. Let's see what Cox does with this one. He's going to boot this one deep. And we're going to let Haley catch it right around the 16. He's going to run to his right, cut back to his left, look for some running room. He has a man loose. 40, 50. He's got to get past the kicker. He does. 30, 20, he tries to be tripped by Nelson, but he's going to score anyway. I can't believe they didn't throw the flag. I cannot believe they didn't throw the flag, but he scores anyway. You'd have to be blinder than Stevie Wonder.
And that gets a touchdown for the Lions. And Grant Haley, wow. We have a bigger night. And the Lions are going to line up here to go for 2. What a run. What an athletic individual. What a blessed talent, Grant Haley.
Here are the Lions on a shotgun set. We put Haley in motion. We fake it to him. Pump fake. Candler's going to throw it. Complete to Wilson, and the Lions tied up 21-all.
Double move there over in the corner. It's solo coverage, and Cyrus darts in. We turn by Grant Haley, and we've seen it, Richard, all night. They
your new
it
score,
short.
GAC 21,
another Rollins. So we're going to kick this one short. And coming up right around his 27 and fighting ahead goes Tershard Kimball Johnson, who
this high scorer get a boost of energy here and get ready to stop this GAC team.
And for the first time this season, the Lions fans are up on their feet. Shotgun set, three receivers left, one right. Spencer takes it, looks downfield. He's under a little bit of pressure. He fires it complete, though, to McGriff. McGriff has it down inside the 30, going to be knocked down to the 20.
What a
44
ball.
Yards, rather.
What a well-turned ball.
Shotgun set. Spencer's your quarterback. Now they go to Nelson as the quarterback. Nelson's going to keep it, call his own number, run left. We miss a tackle on that left side. We're trying to chase him out around the 20. We're going to push him out around the 12.
Cyrus Wilson read the play in the backfield and slipped through the big
block. AC knocking on the door again. We're knotted up 21-21. Spencer's going to send three receivers out to his right. His single setback is Deshaun Daniels. He's going to leave it with Daniels. Daniels is going to go off that left side for 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 yards inside the 5 down to about the 2.
Another big running back for them.
Ball's just inside the 3, down between the 2 and the 3, and Chapel's going to come in at quarterback, go under center. Daniels will be your tailback. Chapel's going to keep in and roll in behind his center. And let's see where he marks it. Does he mark it short? He does score.
Boy, he's left guard. It's something else. Scraping and clawing for points, and all of a sudden we've got a bunch of points here in the second half.
Cox will attempt this extra point. GAC leads it 27-21. High snap. And Cox boots it through. Your new score, GAC 28, Lovett 21. That GAC scoring drive was 63 yards and just 4.
Spencer Lee and Grant Haley deep to receive for the Lions.
Cox is going to pooch this one short. It's going to bound. The Lions are going to have to fall on it. Spencer Lee's going to have to fall on around the 27. And Haley got it. So shotgun set. We put Lee in motion, fake it to him. Candler's going to look, try and launch it downfield for Wilson. And Wilson's going to go up high for it and can't come up with it.
It's Osiris's height. But a good play, the defensive back for
GAC. Again, shotgun set. We fake it to Lee. He's in trouble. Candler's in trouble, and Tony Jones is going to pull him down. Tony Jones Jr. pulls him down. 12, it'll make it 3rd and 22. 3rd and 22 from the 15. Shotgun set. Here they come again. Candler's going to call his own number. He has a little bit of running room up across the 25. Candler up across the 25 to the 28-yard line. He picked up 13. Nobody deep. Wynn Martin standing right around his 13. And he's going to boot this one long. Let's see if we can get a little bit of a roll. We get something of a roll. Down inside the 40 will be rolled down right around the 38-yard line.
So see Coach Muschamp talking about
first and 10 GAC from their own 38. Shotgun set, three receivers to the left. Low snap, he's going to leave it with Nelson. Big Noah Brister's going to pull down Nelson after about a 3-yard pickup up across the 40. Second and 7 GAC, again, that three receivers out to the left, one receiver to this near side. Let's see if the Lions are coming on this. They are. He's dropping straight back. He's in trouble. He's going to go down. Marsteller's going to drop him all the way back around the 27-yard line. He came flashing off the side and dropped Spencer.
A big loss and a big sack for the Lovett defense.
Now it's turnover time. Third and 21, GAC. Shotgun set, three receivers to the right. Low snap again. Spencer takes it, fires it out for Nelson. Stops the clock as it falls incomplete. 6:49 to go, and GAC is going to have to punt it away.
Big stop. Nonetheless, we hope for some good field position if they're going to not kick it to Green. It stands at about midfield almost.
Wood's going to stand right at his 12. He'll get this punt away right around his 15. We almost got it, and he hammers it. Haley has to go back and catch it at the 32.
Grant Haley makes the fair catch.
Yeah,
First and 10 Lions, trailing 28-21, 6:39 to go. We go shotgun set on first and 10. Candler's going to take it, swing it out to Haley, and oh, just falling just beyond his reach. We may run that again. No, we're not. We go shotgun set again. We put Haley in the slot to the right. We have a receiver on this near side. Now we put Haley in motion. We fake it to him. We're going to throw it complete to Jamison. Jamison has some running room. Jamison across midfield, cutting back this near sideline. John Jamison on a fantastic run for the Lions. Gets it into GAC territory and brought down around the 37. Excellent.
He's wide open with a blocker out there and a great run. Great play call by Coach Muschamp.
Shotgun set for the Lions on first and 10 of the GAC 37. Candler runs a slip screen and boys get batted down. And boy, did they sniff that out. Andrew.
Get an interception because he was wide open for another big game. We've got some momentum on offense now.
Shotgun set, two receivers to the left. We're going to fake it to Haley. Candler's going to keep it, try and pick up some running room, but he can't escape Bartolome, and he's going to knock it quickly up to the line. Go Lions. And let's see what we're going to run here out of shotgun. Two receivers to the left, one receiver right. Candler's going to take it, pump fake, try and float it downfield, and it's going to be batted away right at the last second on that far sideline. We tried to catch Marsteller, and the GAC 34. We need another miracle. Shotgun set, bunch set to the left, one receiver to the right. Shotgun set, and Candler's going to call a timeout. The Lions call their first timeout of the second half. Lions on fourth and 7. We have three receivers to this near sideline. Jamison's your single setback. Candler takes into the shotgun. And Lovett's going to call a timeout yet again, burning our second timeout. More score. Same set, fourth and 7, shotgun set. We pump fake it. Candler's going to keep it. He's going to try and get a yard. Candler down inside the 20. Candler inside the 15. Candler's going to get run out around the 3. Willie Candler keeping his feet, cut it to the right, and went for 29 yards and 11 first down inside the 5.
Well, who would have guessed that?
From the 4.
What a call. What a gutsy call.
What a gutsy play by Candler. Shotgun set. Candler takes it, calls his own number. He's going to go down right at the line of scrimmages. A combination of Tony Jones and Bartolome bring shotgun set. We send Wilson to this near side. We're in a pistol set to the left with Haley as your tailback. We flip it to Haley. He cuts back inside. He's going to scramble inside for maybe 2, down to near the 2-yard line. They're going to mark him down at the 3, actually, so just give him a yard.
Well, Grant might get the ball again. Scores 4 touchdowns here.
Now we're going to send and go with a double wing set and have to call a timeout. We went to a double wing set and really didn't have it set up well.
And Lovett, we used it.
Yeah, kind of consider more of him a blocker.
Yep. Here are the Lions, pistol set. We put Marsteller in motion on third and goal from the 2.5. We're going to toss it to Haley. He's going to throw it back for Candler. Caught in the corner of the end zone. Willie Candler reaching back, catches it, diving out of the end zone to score. And the Lions again threaten to tie it up.
What a catch by Willie Candler. He had
looking all back over his head.
And the defender caught on late to the play. The old toss sweep with the quarterback running the boot back around. And Grant, what a throw by Grant. But what an amazing catch by Willie Candler. And let's watch this extra point go through.
Brendan McGowan to boot it. Good snap. And that one's good. McGowan boots it through. Your new score, GAC 28, the Lovett Lions 28. Plays. I cannot describe that catch by Willie Candler any more other than if you can imagine. McGowan tees it up right in the middle of the field on the 40. White neck. Deep, but Chapel's going to gather it in right around the 32-yard line. And Bowden, your linebackers. Shotgun set for Spencer. Spencer takes it, keeps all in number, dives ahead, but loses his footing and falls ahead for maybe a gamble. 25-0 in a big game. Hillgrove, a powerful football team this year. Check that, 2nd and 12. Shotgun set, two receivers to the left. He's going to fake it. He's in trouble. There's a hold, and they're going to float it downfield. What a hold on Jamison. I cannot believe it. From McGriff, it'll bring up 3rd and 12. Clock stop 2:58. We're knotted up 28 all here on the riverbank. Shotgun set, three receivers to the left. Low snap. Spencer takes it, looking to run the screen. Oh,
it's illegal.
No, he actually didn't catch it.
The lineman, he overthrew his receiver.
He overthrew his receiver and now moving up. He'll get this punt. He's standing at his 16. He'll get this punt away right around his 19. Haley standing on the Lovett side of the 50, but the 42. Low snap. We don't rush it. Line drive kick. Haley O lets it go. Oh, my goodness. It's going to bound inside the 25 down to around the 21-yard line. So with 2:42 to go, the Lions have... We're going to send Marsteller and Haley out wide. Shotgun set. We're going to take it, flip it wide to Haley coming to this near side. He's going to pick up 5-6 and get knocked out around the 26. Give him 5. Stops the clock with 2:35. Second and 5 Lions from their 26. We're going to send Marsteller out way wide right. Two receivers left. We put Haley in motion. We fake it to him, pump it, and Wilson's going to catch it up at the 32 for a first down. Make it the 33. And get a nice spot out of that.
Necessarily a hurry up, but you don't feel like the GAC's defense can get set as easily in this situation.
Two receivers right, two receivers left. Here comes the blitz. We fire it complete to Wilson. He's going to get knocked out right around the... Oh, there's a flag. That might have been a late hit. Out of the 36, third play of this drive. So now the Lions go shotgun set, pistol set, two receivers right on first and 10 from the GAC 49. Candler's in trouble. He's going to go down. They get the blitz. We had to get rid of, we should have gotten rid of that. Now the clock really works against us. Shotgun set, two receivers to the right. Candler's gonna take it, call his own number, try and get outside, get a little bit of a block, get another bit of a block, but he's gonna be wrestled down after only about a 4-yard gain. He was looking for yardage, and now GAC's gonna call timeout with a minute. Haley with a 47-yard run. So here's third and 17 from the Lovett 44. Shotgun set. We put Marsteller in motion to this near sideline. We're going to look downfield, have a man
there
open.
Is.
Jameson! 20, 10, 5! John Jameson on the wheel route scores!
What a perfect throw by Willie Candler on the wheel route. Delayed and went out there and he beat his linebacker and just perfectly thrown ball by Willie Candler. And the Lions take a 6-point lead here.
Willie Candler's long pass down the sideline is complete to number 2, John Jameson.
So get a bomb and a perfect pass for a touchdown.
There's a snap. And McGowan boots it through. Great hole by Luke Hart. The ball, Brooks, low snap. Hart gets it down. McGowan boots it through. A minute 27 to go. The Lovett score.
Lions take 35-28 lead here. Minute 27 left.
McGowan to boot it away. White neck deep for GAC. That ball is going to bound low and have to be covered up right at the 20 as it could not be recovered. Deshaun Daniels back there had to.
Missing an exciting football game wherever you are.
Shotgun set for the Spartans. Spencer has two receivers right, two receivers left. Good snap. Spencer takes it, has plenty of time. He fires it over the middle, and McGriff is hit hard by Wilson and cannot hold on. Cyrus Wilson
Dart, and if Cyrus hadn't come in there and jacked that ball, that's probably a completion, and they're up at midfield.
Second and 10 from their own 20. Two receivers left, one receiver right. He's going to roll out. He's going to try and float it out to Nelson. Nelson gathers it in. We're going to knock him down right around the 21. Craig Wilson turned him in. Ian Crosby hustling over, dropped him, and GAC is going to have to come. So it's third and 7 GAC. You know they're in four down territory. They'd be in from their own goal line in four down territory. Shotgun set, two receivers to this near side, one up top. They put a man in motion. He's going to fire it out, complete. And up across the 35 goes McGriff, up across the 45 near midfield. Jeremy McGriff caught it on a beautiful throw.
Pretty good play there by GAC.
First down GAC from their own 48, and he's gonna spike it?
Can you spike it from the shotgun? No, you can't spike it from the shotgun, so that'll be a penalty.
Yeah.
GAC.
That's it. 49 seconds to go. It's second and 4. No, check that. It's second and 18 from the 39. They've got to get to the Lovett 43 for a first down. Shotgun set, two receivers to this near sideline. Spencer's got plenty of time, but he's going to throw it underneath to Nelson. We miss a tackle. He gets across the 40, going to be run out of bounds right around the original line of scrimmage up at the 48 by Julius Holder. For their lives here on the riverbank. Shotgun set, two receivers to this near side. One receiver is White Neck up top. Shotgun set for Spencer. He takes it low snap. He's going to fire it underneath, complete to White Neck, a diving White Neck sliding along the ground and catches it around the 39, stops the clock with 35.
He's out there going to put this junior quarterback on their list next year. He's quite a talent.
Spencer goes under center. Now he's going to, I think, did they call timeout or did he?
That was the spike there.
That was a strange spike because I don't, to go makes it second and 10 from the 40. Shotgun set, three receivers to the right, just one to the left is White Neck. He may look for him again. He is. He's going to float it deep for White Neck, and it's going to be batted away right at the last second by Wynn Martin, almost picked off at the 5. A beautiful pass down that far sideline, but 3rd and 10, 24 seconds to go. The Spartans go shotgun set again. White Neck up top, three receivers to the right. What does Spencer do here? And they move.
Start on that left guard out back in the five. So many big plays in this second half, and we've got a few more left here.
Same set, three receivers right. Spencer takes it. He's under a little bit of pressure. He's going to float it downfield. He's picked off! Grant Haley on a diving catch at the 16, and the Lions are going to Columbus.
Grant Haley with a diving interception. Who else? Why not? I mean, goodness. Play of the game of his life so far. And I don't even know how, but we're going to win this game.
We're under center. Candler's going to take it knee. Does GAC dare call a timeout here? No, they don't. They have a timeout left, but they're going to let this clock run. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5.
Don't you have to call the timeout after the San Diego Chargers fumble in the center?
That does it. The Lovett Lions have stunned the region. The Lions, having to win down throughout this game, come back to win it 35-28 and get to the playoffs when nobody thought they could. A team left for dead last Friday night on Nancy Creek.
A round of cheers and applause for an extremely hard-fought game this evening by both teams.
And the Lions
got some exhausted players down in the end zone. I think just now realizing John Jameson and Grant Haley might need to get an IV or two ready.
The Lions came off the deck, showed their heart.
At this halftime, when
your
they go down
score,
and score right
Lovett
before half, to make it 14-7.
GAC 28. And Lovett advances.
What is the deal with Brad Cox? When he shows up, we always have a big win. He flies in from Texas just to bring us luck. Lovett wins it 35-28, and the playoff streak continues. We go in as a 4 seed, but we head to Columbus. We head to Columbus to play the Carver Tigers of Del McGee.
In the state playoff game, by turning out in force.
I wish I could tell you other scores around Double A. We know Buford was leading 42-7 over Blessed Trinity, so they'll certainly be the 1 seed.
To make Blessed Trinity the 2 seed, and then Westminster Decatur the 3 seed, and that's the 4 seed.
Well. That would appear to be the case.
Nonetheless, the Lions get a victory somehow, some way, with amazing offensive execution at times, and the fans came on the field here and went crazy, and see the handshake here, and that GAC is a talented team, I'm telling you what.
I'm telling you, Coach Coakley has a ball club there.
Kickoff returns, and then that just perfect pass from Willie Candler to John Jameson there for the go-ahead touchdown on a wheel route. Hard to pick a best play of this game. There's so many of them.
And all my children, wherever you've been, in D.C., Auburn, Athens.
That was fun.
Thank you very much for texting me throughout this game.
His tying touchdown.
Wow. Well, we haven't thanked our sponsors, but we'll have another week to thank them. Funny, my godchild is coming in next weekend with a good friend of hers. She's a junior at McLean High School in Virginia. They won the AAA state soccer championship last year. And I'll be in Columbus. I wish she could fly in on Friday, although McLean and Langley are playing tonight for a vital playoff position in Virginia High School football. But we want to thank our sponsors. All I mentioned that about my godchild coming into town is hope she realizes that I may make her take a cab to Athens for the game next Saturday, because I'm going to be a little sleepy coming back.